Erica, I know you have been struggling with weight in the past. I am about 7 kilos overweight at the moment and feel repulsive. Been there, girlfriend. Have much more confidence when I am at my goal weight. But I'm wondering, should I lose the weight and gain the confidence or try to find a way to love myself the way I am right now? In other words, should self-love of the physical body be non-conditional? Absolutely, 100%. And the way the universe works is you cannot get the body you want to love yourself. You have to love yourself, and then the body will be matched vibrationally to you. But I do want to talk about weight loss, because this is something that you have to understand, that when you're manifesting a weight issue or a body issue or a dis-ease or a malfunction or chronic pain, that it is a divine message and a biography of what is manifesting in your subconscious mind, okay? So now that you've heard the other two questions, I don't have to go into a deep journey of understanding your subatomic blueprint. And when, let's take weight, because it's such a common phenomenon, and I suffered from it myself for years and years, used it tactically to both punish and love myself, right? So let's look at all the metaphors of weight first and foremost. Okay, why would someone hold weight, right? Because you know that you feel more like your higher self, you feel more confident, you feel more vibrant, you feel more energized when you're kind of at that goal weight or that normal weight, right? You don't think about body so much because you're not as heavy. Remember the two questions before, I demonstrated what heaviness actually is in physical reality. It's density, it's pain, it's suffering. So I'm going to break down all the things that weight is manifested. First and foremost, extra weight sitting on the body is impacted, compacted, unprocessed, depressed, suppressed emotion. Nowhere else to go, right? Body goes, hey, there's a ton of energy here. Find a place for it. And the brain goes, I want some sugar. I need some sugar. I need some food. And I can't get enough. I can't get enough. Because what we're going to do is materialize a box for the stuffed emotion. Okay. So now we've got the heaviness of the emotion contained in a physical property, which is a fat cell that is designed to grow and expand depending on what energy is inside. Okay. So that's number one. Number two, manifestation of always having to wait. Wait, 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 wait. You probably have triggers in boredom. You probably have triggers in waiting. You probably have triggers in waiting on others. You probably have triggers in waiting on stuff or things or ideas or opportunities. You've also been let down through your waiting. Let down heavy, right? You have been let down, okay? So I've been let down. I'm carrying a ton of emotion that I do not want to know about, so I'm shoving it somewhere else, and I'm waiting, okay? Also, we use weight to hide, all right? The bigger I get, the less people notice me. The bigger I get, the less I want to go outside. The bigger I get, the less I want to speak because I'm not worth speaking. I'm not worth it. So it's a way for us to stay trapped in our pain. And it's usually a cycle. That's why when you start to lighten up, definition of enlightenment, you begin to feel more confident and you begin to express emotion. So a lot of people will just change their diet, start exercising, and start burning out all that emotional storage because they're self-loving, right? As long as we're not exercising to punish ourselves or eat to punish ourselves, it won't backfire. It won't go to yo-yo. It won't come back around because the further we punish ourselves, the further heavier we get later. So I would say, let's look at what metaphor both most fits with your storyline and say, okay, if this is suppressed emotion, how could I love the emotion that's sitting inside of me? You see how I'm not asking you to love you, because you already love you. You just don't love the baggage. You don't love the memories. You don't love the pain. You love you. You just don't love the things that have happened that ego keeps trying to get you to take score of. You know, you don't like the weight. Therefore, I don't like the weight. The universe only says yes. It doesn't speak in that idea. It just, it's very analytical and very autistic in the way it expresses itself. Oh, you don't like waiting? Well, here's some weight because you said yes, right? Being let down, you know, being pushed into a heavy position. Doesn't feel like you, doesn't resonate with you, So disappointed, resentment is at the baseline of your weight that you're carrying. And it's interesting, 7 kilos, what's the representation of the number 7? Okay, 7 is a number of a cycle, which means that an entire cycle is manifested in your weight. So all of the 7 cycles are permeating in that system. And your job is not to necessarily love you, which you can't because you already do, but love the emotion impacted. Find out how to weight differently. Use my methods, practice, prepare, play. Okay, you never have to weight again. And see who let you down and who is letting you down, and look in the mirror at who's really letting you down. Biohack. Okay, great Q&A.